The Cybertruck is the perfect mom and family car. First of all, huge back trunk. With the tonneau cover, you never have to worry about all your kids' stuff getting wet or your groceries. Everything stays nice and dry. The doors open to 90 degrees, which is super great for loading in kiddos. Even with two car seats in the back and my 6'3 husband in the front, I still got plenty of room.
It's seat 7.
Another great mom feature is all the space in this truck. I love this tray down here, which is perfect for a diaper bag or a purse. And check this out, a hidden drawer for anything important.
Oh my God, where did that come from? Did you know that was there?
But best of all, you look like a total badass driving your kids around in this.
When you become a parent, no one thinks you're badass. In fact, my kids tell me I'm cringe every day.
One of the greatest things about owning an electric vehicle, specifically a Tesla, other than the Cybertruck being the best looking vehicle ever produced ever, is that after charging for about 12 hours overnight, and me not being able to drive it during any sort of emergency because it's charging, I have a whopping 42% battery, which means I can go 133 miles anywhere I want to go. But even better is that 42% battery only cost me about $40 or $50 to fill up. Can your gas car do that? With a gas car, I'd have to pay about $50 for a full tank to go 500 miles. Why would I do that when I can pay $40 or $50 to go 133 miles in an electric car? And with an electric car, you have to wait 10 or 12 or 15 or 40, 50, 60 hours to charge it. With a gas car, you have to wait 3 minutes at the gas station. It just doesn't make sense to buy a gas car anymore at all.
Hier stehen die berühmten Teslas am Flugplatz in Neu-Hardenberger Falde. Tausende. Auf 700.
Screen off to see what's going there. 120, it's pulsing right now, not sure why. See, I'm right next to the fridge and it's completely nothing is happening outside here. Now when the microwave is off, you can see, well, it's barely nothing, zero coming out of this fella. But when we turn it on, see that from this distance we're getting 360 milliwatts per meter squared. About half a meter away, the levels have dropped down to 100 milliwatts per meter squared. So that's the kind of levels you're getting when you're using mobile data, Wi-Fi, uploading and downloading data right next to you. So yeah, using your phone next to your head is like this much away from a microwave oven.
That's 100, and you got 100 in the cabin here, everywhere. It goes out to about, it's 100, it's just 100 everywhere basically in this car, and it's on, but you're not driving. It's everywhere actually. 75 back here, so it's buzzing at the moment. I don't know if maybe this is a demonstrator one. It goes up to 150 over here.
Try this bit over here.
And all right. So we took test drive yesterday. We were wiped out, yeah, and I did get a headache afterwards. But I was saying it was because we were wiped out. Yeah, so this is like, you got a big mobile phone just constantly around you.
You guys, you're not gonna believe this. Right now, I have to videotape this. This is a brand new Tesla. She doesn't even have plates on it, right? Just look at this. We're on a freeway in California where it's bumper to bumper. Go slow, go slow, go slow right now. So good. She is out. Sleeping completely, knocked out, and this car is driving her. Look at how dangerous that is. You guys, I'm sorry. That is too damn dangerous. Sleeping and this car is driving you? Are you nuts?